The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Good afternoon and welcome to this service of lessons and carols for Christmas Eve. For those of you who I have not met, my name is Pastor Hans Borch, and I'm the interim pastor here at St. Stephen's while Pastor Rich is recovering from his surgery, and hopefully he will be back in the new year. This is a candlelight service, and so I would ask you to remember to leave the lit candles always upright and tilt the unlit candles towards them in order to have them lit. One other thing that you'll note by omission is that there is no offering in the bulletin. There is an offering plate at the back of the church, so if you would like to leave a donation, you're welcome to leave that on your way out if you haven't already done so. If I don't have an opportunity to greet you later or say anything to you, I wish you all a blessed Christmas as we welcome the Christ child into our homes and into our hearts. Many ages from the time God created the heavens and the earth, and then formed men and women in God's own image. Long after the great flood, when God made a rainbow in the sky to shine forth as a sign of the covenant. 21 centuries from the time of the promise given to Abraham and Sarah. 13 centuries after Moses led the people of Israel out of Egypt and Miriam danced in freedom. 1,100 years from the time of Ruth and the Judges, 1,000 years from the anointing of David as king in fulfillment of the times and years and months and days discerned by the prophets, in the 194th Olympiad and 752nd year of the founding of the city of Rome, the 42nd year of the reign of Octavian Augustus, while the whole world enjoyed a span of peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God, Son of the eternal Father, desiring to sanctify the world by his most merciful coming, being conceived by the Holy Spirit and 9 months of growth in the womb of his mother, now in our own times is the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, God made flesh. I would invite you to stand as you are able for our gathering song, O Come All Ye Faithful, number 283.
Oh,
I'd invite you to follow the litany for light as printed in our bulletin. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Those who dwell in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. We have beheld Christ's glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. In him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's pray. Glorious God, on this Christmas Eve, we sing beloved songs of Bethlehem, of shepherds and angels, of Mary and Joseph, and the infant Jesus, our Savior. Is there yet a new song that we could sing to you? A song to be learned from the heavens and the earth, where the roar of the sea, the exultation of the fields, and the joy of the trees are already raised in a chorus of glad rejoicing, ready to welcome you. Even if no ear can hear your coming, help us to hear the music of creation. And then with the whole cosmos, we will sing of your salvation, declare your glory, and in the crescendo of praise, bless your name, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Ever-Living Father, Prince of Peace. Amen. I invite you to be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was complete chaos, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. And let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. Holy wisdom, holy words. Thanks be to God.
Our next hymn is hymn number 282, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear," and we'll sing verses 1, 3, and 4.
Thank you. A reading from the prophet Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. Holy wisdom, holy words.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Holy wisdom, holy words.
Thanks be to God.
Our next hymn is hymn number 272, "Lo, How a Rose Ere Blooming," and we'll sing verses 1, 2, and 4.
The fourth reading is a reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be pregnant from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to divorce her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall become pregnant and give birth to a son. They shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from his sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she gave birth to a son, and he named him Jesus. Holy wisdom, holy words, thanks be to God.
Reading from the Gospel of Luke. Now in that same region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this shall be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on peace and on earth peace amongst those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. And when they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. And Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as it had been told them. Holy wisdom, holy words. Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand as you're able for our next hymn, Angels from the Realms of Glory, number 275. And again, we'll sing verses 1, 2, and 4.
Thank you.
Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Please be seated. There was a bishop in the Episcopal Church in the United States who posted a number of videos on YouTube called A Monk in the Midst. And during one of these videos, he had an occasion to talk to a man named Fred and his six-year-old son named Sam. He talked to them about what they were going to do on Christmas Day. And the father explained that they would get up, they would open their gifts, and then they would go to church. Sam looked at him and said, "Church? We're going to church on Christmas?" Fred looked at him and said, "Well, yes, of course. That's what Christmas is all about. It's about Jesus' birth and God coming to us." And Sam said, I know all that. But church on Christmas? Church wrecks everything. Truer words were never spoken. Church wrecks everything. Yes, it does. And tonight we come to encounter the only church, not only the church that wrecks everything, but also the child who was born to wreck everything. I mean, it may sound a little odd in the face of our culture's approach to Christmas and maybe even a little bit disquieting in an age where terrorism and war dominates the news cycle. But we dare not forget the scandal of both the cradle and the cross. And we dare not be lulled by our culture's attempts to sentimentalize Christmas. I mean, we do it all the time, each and every one of us. And it even happens in church. Think about some of our favorite Christmas hymns. The words conspire to tame this feast day into something more palatable. Dare we even say something more nice? So consider the opening words of O Little Town of Bethlehem. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Those are lovely words by Phillips Brooks. But if we think about the tumultuous history of the Middle East, imaging Bethlehem as peaceful expresses more of a longing for a future than our present reality. Even today, on Christmas 2023, Bethlehem is quiet. There is no tree in the square. There are no decorations. There are no crowds. There are no people. There are no services. And what about away in a manger? Away in a manger tells us the cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. Really? No crying? Any nurse or doctor would tell you that that's a zero on the Apgar scale, and they would immediately start resuscitation methods. These images may just be conspiring to sentimentalize the scandal of Christmas. What about the emotional expectations of the holidays? You know all about it. All those family, happy family get-togethers that often don't turn out so great as you had hoped they would. Or the longing for an estranged relationship that would magically be put back together again and resolved in some kind of Christmas miracle. And of course, there's the cultural pressure to overconsume. And whether it's going overboard in buying gifts and presents and dreading the credit card bill when it comes in January, or the overeating and overdrinking and dreading what the scale will tell you in January, between the sentimental, emotional burdens and the unrealistic cultural expectations. Perhaps we need this child of God to wreck what we've made of Christmas. The reality is that we come together today to pay honor to the one who came to wreck all of that. This child's birth was the plan of a subversive God who snuck in the back door of history on a mission to wreck everything. Coming in as one of us, a vulnerable, poor, and powerless human being, he came to upend the world as we have constructed it. He came to wreck our selfishness and our narcissism so that we might be able to love God and others and to receive that love in return. He came to wreck our fear of death so that we might be able to live more fully in this life and altogether. He came to wreck our political systems, those systems that choose who's in and who's not, so that all of God's children could be included in the kingdom. He came to tear down our tendency of tribalism, pitting one group against another. And trust me when I say this, we still have tribalism today. We just name it differently. We call it political parties, ethnic groups, even faith denominations. He came to break down our economy of values, to build a different one based on valuing the eternal rather than things that pass away. Jesus came to break down our ideas of family and to embrace a wider view of family, a vision of God's family that includes all people, not just the ones like us. Yes, he came to wreck every structure that we try to build, which puts us ahead of everybody else in the world. And as he would later tell his followers, he came not to serve, not to be served, but to serve. And he calls us to follow in the same way. This is no small thing that he calls us to. For 2,000 plus years, people have come together to mark the birth of Christ as God's subversive way of dwelling among us and wrecking everything that man has made, human beings have made, for the sake of bringing about something greater, something that we couldn't even ask or imagine, to mark a vision of the kingdom of God unfolding right here, right now in our midst. Regardless of our fears, regardless of any conflict that we may be experiencing, I pray that this holy child, this holy one-man wrecking crew, I pray this child disrupt your life. Disrupt your life this season so that he might plant the grace of God in your heart, and he might, and that you might come to know the love of God, so deeply meant for each and every one of you. Amen.
Matthew 2, verses 1 to 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star in the east and have come to pay him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'For you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the Magi and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. And then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word that I may also go and pay him homage.' And when they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen in the east, until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they knelt down and paid him homage. And then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." Holy wisdom, holy words.
Thanks be to God. I invite you to join us in our next hymn, number 277, Away in a Manger. This is the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world knew him not. He came into his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the gospel of the Lord. Our next hymn is hymn number 296, What Child Is This? I would invite you to stand as you are able. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Creator of the universe. From old you have led your people by night and day. May the light of your Christ make our darkness bright. For your word and your presence are the light of our pathways. And you are the light and life of all creation. Amen. hymn number 281. I invite you to follow the responsive prayer as printed in our worship guide. It is you, loving God, who lights our path with truth. Your word, Jesus, is true. In his light, draw all to the manger to gather in wonder with the shepherds. In his light, draw all to the manger to kneel in reverence with the wise ones. In his light, draw all to the manger, to sing for joy with the angels. In the brightness of his life, cast away the darkness of injustice, poverty, and hunger in the world. It is you, loving God, who meets us on our way. In the light of Christ, show the world the way of life. As our Savior taught us, let us joyously gather our prayers together as we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Amen. I invite you to blow out your candles, and our next hymn, our sending hymn, is from our worship book 267, Joy to the World.
Great.
Go in peace. Have a blessed Christmas.
Thank you.